This is a Fox News alert. The death toll rising following that Taliban attack in Kabul yesterday. At least 103 killed and more than 230 wounded when the terrorists drove an ambulance filled with explosives through a security checkpoint.
Our next guest points to Pakistan as a key player in the bloodshed. Gary Burnson is a retired CIA station chief. He joins us now to explain. Gary, explain to our viewers, you know, a bomb goes off in a secure area in Kabul, and ultimately where people are, obviously you've got the folks responsible for that, but people are pointing across the border to Pakistan to say, we don't fix this until we address that. What do you say to that?
Good morning, Pete.
Good morning.
Part of the problem, of course, a larger part of the problem, is that Afghanistan has been dragged into the larger conflict between India and Pakistan. Since partition in 1947, India and Pakistan have been at each other's throats because Pakistan was trying to seize Kashmir. Between India and Pakistan, there's a border, but they don't call it a border. They call it the line of actual control. That's where their military forces are. So everything Pakistan does is in the context of its struggle with India. So they've looked at Afghanistan, Pakistan has, for strategic depth. They want to control all of Afghanistan because their fear is if the Indians invade Pakistan, they want to be able to fall back into Afghanistan. And that was the reason that Pakistan created the Taliban in the 1990s. And at one point, the Pakistanis even thought about storing nuclear weapons in Afghanistan. How's that for crazy? So the point here is that with the Americans on the ground there, and the Americans have allied themselves with India, India is great, gaining an influence inside of Afghanistan. The Indians are giving like $1 billion worth of scholarships. They're doing all sorts of things there. This really makes Pakistan concerned and very, very worried. But the point is this is, instability in Afghanistan or recontrol, if the Taliban were to seize control of Afghanistan again, the Pakistanis would control it, they would control that space, and they look at it in the larger narrative of their struggle with India. But the problem is, they're killing Americans.
Yes.
The Pakistani support to the Taliban, to the Haqqani network, to any of these militant groups, these 24 militant groups that have operated over their borders, and the million jihadis that have been trained on their territory in the last 20 years, injures and hurts and kills Americans right now. And so, therefore, President Trump's statements against them were spot on. We can't do anything here until this problem is fixed in Pakistan, and we may even have to start crossing the border more aggressively to deal with these with the Pakistanis if they don't stop this.
So is that the plan, Gary, then? I mean, look here, it's clear that Pakistan is providing for the safe haven for the Taliban. Let's just call it exactly what it is. Do they go across the border? I mean, let's not forget that bin Laden was found basically in the shadows of Pakistan's version of West Point, and yet when we asked him where he was, he said, nope, no idea where he is. Do we go in?
Yeah.
What does the president do?
Well, the point here is we have to act against those militant organizations in those sanctuaries. And we can either do it or we can do it with surrogates. The point is look, I was the person that was the architect of what we did in Tora Bora, and the Pakistanis helped bin Laden get out there, too. So, you know, so I was thrilled to see the SEAL teams killed bin Laden at that point. But the Pakistanis have been playing a double game against America for the last 30 years. Therefore, we need to cut them off politically, cut them off economically. We need to put significant pressure on them. And they have been significant sponsors of jihadist terrorism for the last 30 years, and President Trump is calling them to account. But the Pakistanis, they won't say it publicly. They'll say, oh, they think that they're like Elliot Ness, that they're fighting terrorism. They're fighting these people on their territory. And they have put some pressure on them. But look, they could turn over Siraj Haqqani to us tomorrow.
Maybe if the president continues the pressure, we will get him back, and we should. Thank you for giving us a lot of insight in this. A lot of people don't know all the background, and you really were pretty amazing in explaining it to us.
You know
Thank you
stuff.
So much, Gary.